Hello everyone! Today we're going to take a quick look at The Last Voyage of the Demeter. Directed by André Uvredal and starring Corey Hawkins, Aisling Francesi, and Liam Cunningham. This is based on the captain's log from the novel Dracula. The Demeter is en route from Transylvania to London in what will end up being the ship's final voyage. And don't tell me that's a spoiler, the novel is 100 years old. It is carrying 50 large wooden crates with a very creepy looking sigil on them. And things get even creepier when something starts picking off the crew one by one. I imagine it's quite challenging to adapt a lengthy novel and cram as much as possible into about 2 hours of a movie. It's something else entirely to adapt a single chapter of a novel and somehow stretch that out into 2 hours. On paper, that sounds like a very bad idea, and yet, somehow they made it work. If you don't know, the events in the novel Dracula are not told as they happen. They are told after the fact through letters and journal entries, that kind of thing. The captain's log from the ship the Demeter is one such entry in Dracula, and it makes for a creepy little mini horror story all on its own. And similar to the book, the movie is told pretty much entirely as a flashback. The first thing we see is the wreckage of the Demeter, and then we go back to just before it sets sail on what would be its final voyage. And you know something bad is going to happen right away, even if you're not familiar with the story. Before they even leave Varna, the entire town is seriously creeped out by the cargo that this ship is carrying. In fact, after they load the cargo, they don't even ask for payment. They're just happy that whatever is in that cargo is on its way to London and is now somebody else's problem. And the open seas are a very good setting for a horror movie. You're out in the middle of nowhere, completely cut off from the rest of the world, and there is nowhere to run. Or swim, as it were. And there's that very slow building of dread as everyone keeps getting picked off one by one in the middle of the night. Some of them just get killed outright, and some of them meet a much crueler fate. In either case, it ends up being quite messy. There are some very unsettling moments involving the demise of the crew. The movie does take a few liberties with the original story. For one thing, there are a few more people on board. You have Corey Hawkins' character Clemens, who is a doctor by trade, but has had a lot of trouble finding work because fucking white people. But he does manage to get a spot on the Demeter, mainly because no one else will take the job. The captain, played by Liam Cunningham, has brought his grandson along and his dog. And this is a minor spoiler, but John Wick would not like this movie. And Aisling Francesi plays Anna, an unwitting slave of Dracula who has been smuggled on board in one of the crates. And while in the original story, Dracula is pretty much content to silently pick people off in the middle of the night, not everyone in this version of the story is that lucky. The visual effects are pretty good overall, especially considering the movie's relatively low budget. Part of that is they do a pretty good job keeping Dracula hidden most of the time, which is a good call. You don't want to expose the monster too early. And he has a very monstrous appearance when we finally do see him. He's much more Nosferatu than Bela Lugosi. And the cast did a pretty good job overall. I don't know that anyone necessarily stood out, but they were all solid. I do have some minor issues with the story. Considering how many friggin' crates Dracula brought on board that ship, it's a little weird that they only found one slave among the boxes. After they found Anna, I figured once they started going through the crates, they would have found more people that Dracula had brought on board, either as slaves or snacks. Or possibly both. And it would have helped to keep Dracula's presence hidden a bit more, because he started chowing down on the livestock on the first day. I mean, come on, Drac, you gotta pace yourself. That food has got to last you the entire voyage, and it's a long one. And I do think it maybe took them a little too long to figure out that they should probably start searching the crates, and maybe a little too long to figure out what to do after they realized they had a friggin' monster on board. And I felt like the climax didn't quite hit as hard as it could have, because it's really all about the remaining crew at that point trying to take out Dracula, even if it means they have to take him down with them. And the problem with that is, we know the story. The captain's log happens very early on in Bram Stoker's novel. Unless there's a huge friggin' twist in the movie, we know he survives. There is a possibility that some members of the crew will survive. I figured going in that members of the crew who were not in the original story probably had a better chance. But there's no way the vampire is dying before he gets to London. Overall, I don't think it's perfect, but I still thought they did a pretty good job with this story overall. Considering that they adapted a single chapter of a book into a 2-hour movie, it is far better than it has any right to be. I think it would have worked well as part of a larger story, but this bombed at the box office, so I don't think that's gonna happen. But I do think it's a decent horror flick, and it's at least worth a rental. And that's all I have to say about The Last Voyage of the Demeter. Till next time, take care.